automotive world, when we think about electric cars of the future, every data which is related to the battery, for example. So from the raw material of lithium all the way to the electric car and even further to the recycling. The whole life cycle, let's say, of an electric car. Mm-hmm. And therefore, it's also very clear that the data which will be shared in Catena-X as a network are focused on the industrial data.
Okay.
So primarily, and this is for the first release, when we release Catena-X now, it will be materials management data.
Okay.
So for material traceability, from a fully assembled car to the raw material,
okay,
all the data and the material codes. Second, we will also have CO2 data, because sustainability are one of the key use cases and the driver, which means carbon footprint data from the raw material all the way to the
battery.
Exactly.
Export.
Then we will have quality data. Why? Because quality defects and quality management data are a huge, huge factor on cost improvement. Also can be shared. And last but not least, we have logistics and planning data. Everything what OEMs can share around their planning of models or different cars, and suppliers can share from their side around their capacity, which means semiconductor companies or whatever. So it's the core material. That's parts traceability.
Okay.
It's carbon footprint tracking for CO2. It's demand and capacity planning for this one, and it's quality. What I can say, we are planning to have an adoption by end of 2023 from 1,000 partners on the network. Member company for the General Association is really all about joining the community, building standards, for example. Look, if we want to exchange data, for example, around the vehicle by itself, we're always talking about a digital twin. No one has a blueprint how this digital twin should look like. So the community need really to align on which standard do we want to use for the digital twin, which data structure do we want to, or take another example, product carbon footprint. There is no rule book currently around how the automotive industry want to exchange CO2 data. And this is all in the association. This is, of course, centralized and discussed from all the members. So, but a hub, and this is also what we realized very soon, there are always local or regional specifics what we need to consider. The French automotive market is ticking a little bit different than the German one. The Korean automotive market is ticking different than the Japanese one. So you need these hubs also to drive the localization, to get the regional activities going, and to operate also Catena-X on a very regional basis. So there are always three dimensions of Catena-X when we designed it. First, Catena-X as association, what we discussed, the community, the standards, and everything. Second, Catena-X, the development project or the development environment. We decided 1.5 years ago that 28 companies investing into Catena-X to build the core of the software. And now, very important, A, this first development project does not need to be the only one. We can have multiple projects because maybe there is another use case in Korea. There is another technical requirements what we need to have. So we can call off different development projects within this environment, first thing. Second thing, and that's why it makes so special, the nucleus of Catena-X. So how we exchange data, how two parties shake the hand and trust each other, how the brokerage runs. This is mainly built on an open source stack. So the software what the development consortia is producing is not owned by a company. It's not owned by, you know, a big automotive OEM like Volkswagen. It's also not owned by a big IT vendor like SAP. So we are all contributing into this open source community, and we can publish it, and everyone in the world can basically take this. However, and this is now the last piece, if you want to use that software, someone needs to take this software and put it into the operations. And for the operations, this is the last dimension, we clearly also defined, if you really want to have a decentralized network, there cannot be the one only operating company or only one operating environment. You can have multiple environments which are using the software and sharing the data over there. Not battery passport is one that we say. The battery need to be tracked and the battery need to be assembled in the following way. And what we realized, Naya, especially for the battery business, there are 5 to 10 initiatives all around the world who want to tackle exactly this problem. And it's the World Business Council for Sustainability, it's the Global Battery Alliance, it's Mobility Data Space. So all these different initiatives are actually, you know, already addressing and discussing how can we assemble this battery passport topic.
Okay.
And what we from Catena-X did, we said, okay, let's talk and collaborate with all these initiatives and try to harmonize it into one agreed standard. Because in the Global Battery Alliance, it's not only automotive companies, it's also other industries. What we can try to do is speak and consolidate for the automotive industry. So what we are doing from a business perspective, we are taking the insights from all these different initiatives and in one big work group, we consolidate and we agree on one standard. And this one standard has been now released in one first white paper. It's called the Product Carbon Footprint Rulebook.
This is already published.
Already published.
Okay.
So that's the first version about how to calculate the product carbon footprint of a vehicle in the future.
Okay.
Of course, first release, no? Very basic, but further releases will come. And there as well, I mean, now if the business is clear how to calculate, then it's always, and you have to keep in mind from a business perspective, this is a three-dimension problem. Scope 1, 2, within the company, you need to calculate your product carbon footprint, CO2, for this bottle. Scope 3, which is coming from the other companies. And especially if we say, hey, I want to know for fully assembled car, the CO2 footprint, I need to go all the way down really to the raw material. We need to know what is the CO2 emission from the lithium in the mine somewhere in Latin America, for example. And this is exactly where Catena-X comes into play, because with Catena-X, we can connect the dots of the value chain and drive all the way down and can get the data from all the different companies who are contributing. Carbon emission doesn't end where the product ends.
Yeah, right.
It also needs to consider the logistic processes for it.
Yeah.
Everything what is surrounding and contributing to this product carbon footprint.
Okay.
But we believe as an entire industry and also as the IT vendors of the industry, if we don't start trying to measure this and also not trying to include this, we will never have a proper carbon footprint of a product. If you think about the automotive industry is one of the broadest and most complex industry at all. So there are challenges for sure. Yeah? However, companies clearly have a benefit if they join early to influence and to shape Catena-X. And this is depending on standards, on certification, on different use cases. Whatever bothers us, early movers always will have the chance to influence and shape the system at the beginning rather than following and just using the system. Yeah, so this early adoption, and this is also how we always saw it, no? Take our strategy from IT or as a software vendor like SAP, we always said, now we can sit now and wait and hope everything will be better in the future with sustainability and the industry will agree on that we can exchange the data somehow. Or we can really try to be a pioneer and work together with the industry and change the complete industry from one day to another. Yeah? So being a front runner and doing something good for the entire industry, this was our interest why we joined at the regional side. Regulatory requirements will start.
Okay.
Yeah? And what I'm always seeing, you need to start making your strategy for how do I want to calculate my carbon footprint. Okay. So what we predict, it also will not take 1 year or 2 year to have a smooth implemented carbon footprint calculator. This will take 5 years minimum.
5 years. Okay.
But if you move early now, you get yourself in shape already and you also move towards more sustainable processes. And yes, carbon footprint is maybe the first step to gain transparency.
Okay.
But what we clearly see, and this is one of the next use cases which immediately follows after the carbon footprint calculation, it's circularity. Why?
Okay.
Because if you can track down all the carbon footprint, you know the value chain. And you know which component, which raw material was used to assemble the car.
Okay.
And what we know with changing the automotive industry, the reusage of components will be super critical and super valuable for a lot of companies in the future.
Because of the regulation?
No, because also as a future business model.
Ah, okay.
If we really want to be sustainable, or if we really want to be sustainable in automotive, we cannot just live like the last 50 years in automotive. Mm-hmm. Think about it. At the end of the life cycle, currently, only 7-9% of the cars and the components are reused.
Okay.
Everything else is scrapped. And there is for batteries, for lithium, sell the metals, for plastics. This is way too valuable that we're not going to use it.
Mm-hmm.
There are dedicated OEMs and companies who are focusing now on this recycling market for circular economy. Why?
Okay.
Because at the end of the life cycle, we need to dismantle the cars.
Mm-hmm.
We need to reshape them and get the components back to the suppliers.
Mm-hmm.
And if I know the value chain, like CO2 carbon footprint, I know exactly, hey, this supplier was selling me, for example, the lithium. I can give him back the raw material. This one is selling the plastic. I can give back the plastic. So we're going to do also a new business model.
Okay.
And this only happens if you start now. And this is really something what I see, that companies join Catena-X because there are new businesses also in there. We have OEMs already in Germany. They are building up so-called dismantling factories.
Okay.
So at the end of the life cycle, they have special factories just on deassembling the cars and reusing the metals, the cell, the materials, the plastics, the chips, everything what is relevant for the battery. We need to find this open system. And the feedback is really that we recognize that it's received well. Huh?
Received well.
Yeah.
And they want you to participate soon.
I hope so.
Okay.
This is, of course, I mean, for us, it's really also now the point of proving and also realizing Catena-X. What we can say from SAP, we are fully behind Catena-X and behind the strategy. So we will, for example, integrate all the Catena-X services in the SAP software that our customers can decide if they want to share data. They can just turn on the switch and then they can share through the Catena-X world.